You know, we just finished up our services here in Tacoma, and today we were focusing on, you know, Romans chapter 10, and we were looking at gospel preaching, and we were talking about what does it mean to be someone who is called by God, sent by God to preach the gospel. As Christians, we are all called and sent by God to preach the gospel. We talked about how we can do that informally in our conversations, in the relationships that we have, as we talk with people, as we dialogue, discuss, do life together. There are opportunities that come about for us to be able to, you know, share and communicate the gospel. And I was just wondering, like, do you want to grow in your ability to have gospel conversations with your friends and with your family? My assumption is that you do. And so to help you along that journey, we wanted to offer a resource to you. It's a book. It's a book that's called I Once Was Lost. And this is actually a book that myself and the staff went through. We took a couple of months and we just read through this, and we would read a chapter a week and then talk about it and discuss it together. It was very, very helpful. This book is kind of focused on how to share the gospel with people in a postmodern skeptical world and worldview, how we can engage with people in our day. And one of the things that I found really helpful about this book is it talked about kind of the progression of faith that someone goes on, that there are actually some thresholds that someone must kind of encounter in order to get from one place to the next in their faith journey, that they kind of start in one place and then there's a threshold that they've got to make it over to get to the next place and so on and so forth. And so what I'd like to do is just take a couple minutes to share these thresholds with you, but I do recommend and encourage that you encourage you to just go ahead and get this book yourself. And then you can read through it, and even you could do so with some friends, and then you could discuss it with them, as I think that would actually be not only fun, but probably really helpful as you explore the ideas in this book. And so here's the five thresholds that a person encounters as they're on their faith journey to become a Christian. Right, the first is this. The first threshold is that they need to have a relationship in which they can be trusting a Christian. Right? So if you have a friend who's not a Christian and you're their friend, well, then guess what? They've made it to threshold number one, which is simply to meet someone who's a Christian and to build a friendship so that they can start to trust someone who's a Christian. You know, oftentimes what happens is as we develop relationships, as we build trusted friendships, then our preconceived ideas and notions change. And so if someone's on a faith journey and they're not a Christian, really the first thing that we want to see happen is for them to build a relationship with a Christian. And then that starts to lead to threshold number two. The second threshold is becoming curious, right? Becoming curious about Jesus, right? As someone is in a relationship with a Christian, they start to realize that this person's life is different than my life. They do things that I don't do. They say things that I don't really say or talk about. They're kind of thinking about things that maybe haven't been thinking about. And what that does inevitably is it leads to some curiosity. And that person who's not a Christian, who's starting to seek spiritual things, becomes curious. And as they become curious, they start to ask questions. You know, questions about your faith, questions about Jesus, questions about the Bible. And that gives opportunity for there to be lots of dialogue and discussion. Which really starts to lead to the threshold number three. The third threshold is opening up to change. It's one thing to actually hear the truth of Jesus. It's a whole nother thing to actually being open to embracing that truth. And in order for someone to become open to change, they have to be willing to question their own worldview. They have to be willing to question their own lifestyle to be open to maybe changing their worldview or changing their lifestyle. Indeed, threshold number three is probably the most challenging for someone because it requires an openness to change their life and change the way that they've done life. And we all know that change can be difficult. It can be challenging. And so as you're journeying with someone and you've started to build a relationship with them and they become curious to the things of Jesus and to what it means to be a follower of Jesus, as they become curious, inevitably, as you have dialogue and discussion, there'll be opportunities for you to start to really kind of prod their heart and ask them, challenge them, question them, like, are you willing to change this? Would you consider this? What if your life was different in this way? And what that does is it gets them to be at a place where they can start to envision life differently than it has been for them. Maybe they can even start to envision what a Christian life would look like for them. which leads to the fourth threshold. The fourth threshold is seeking after God, right? As someone becomes open to change, at that point, you can encourage them and invite them to seek after God, to not just know a Christian or to not just know the things about Jesus, but to actually start to actually seek Jesus himself so that they can know Jesus personally and relationally. This is really where it becomes less about God as a concept or an idea and more about God as a person that you can have a relationship with. And as a person starts to see, okay, God isn't just, you know, an idea, but I can actually have a personal relationship with God, that inevitably leads to threshold number five. And the fifth threshold is entering the kingdom. This is really the place where you're able to invite them into the kingdom. You know, we've been talking about Jesus and you've had a lot of questions about Jesus and, you know, you've learned that following Jesus means having a relationship with God. But I want to invite you to actually take that step of faith and to put your faith in Jesus and to have a relationship with him. You could even go so far as you invite them into the kingdom to say, would you consider praying with me? Can I teach you how to pray so that you can start to have a relationship with God yourself? Right now, in sharing all of this with you, my hope is simply to give you some things to consider. You know, you as a Christian are not only called to, you know, proclaim the gospel, to share the gospel, and not only is God sending you, he is sending you to proclaim and share the gospel, but you're also called to love the people whom God is sending you to. You're called to be in relationship with them. And as someone is on a faith journey, obviously they're kind of going from one place to the next. They're going from a place of not knowing Jesus to becoming someone who not only knows about, but knows Jesus personally and intimately. And it's a great privilege to get to journey with someone on that faith, that journey of discovery, that journey of fellowship with God. And so I want to encourage you to see the work of preaching the gospel informally, to see evangelism as something that you do in the context of relationships with the people you already are in relationship with. And I want you to see it not as a one and done. You know, it's not like there's a box to check that says, I shared the gospel. Yep, I did that. Now move on. But not like that. Rather, it's just an ongoing conversation. It's an ongoing discussion. Your goal is to simply share Christ with them, love them the way that Jesus loves them, and to try to see if they can move from one place to the next, one little faith step at a time, from one step to the next, to the next, to the next, so that there's a progression, so that they're moving closer to Jesus. So hopefully this helps you. Hopefully this inspires you. Hopefully this equips you to be able to go and make a difference as you go and make disciples.